Hello and welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how to obtain the equivalent circuit from the Nyquist plot using the CHI-660E software. In this video, I will use the EIS data which already I have obtained earlier. That means that you can do it later, not during the experiment. You can do it later also. What you have to do, first you have to switch on the CHI instrument. I have switched on the machine. Now let's open the software. And as I have switched on the machine, what I have to do, I have to go to the setup section, then I have to perform the hardware test once again. So everything is all right, okay. Now let's browse the file. Here I have opened existing EIS data. You can see this is minus Z and this is Z dash. This is imaginary part of the impedance in negative, and this is the real part of the impedance. Let's see now how to simulate this curve. For this, you have to go to this sim, that means simulation, then go to mechanism. So you can see it, and you have to plot, you have to bring some circuit element. Let's first bring one resistance, then one capacitance. I am going to fit this EIS plot into Randall circuit, then another resistance, then let's connect it. Yes, complete. Now what you have to do, you have to click this fit. Now the software has started working, but you see that this is high error. You can see this figure, it's almost 31.6% error, so it's not going to work. Now we have to change this circuit. We have to reduce this error. Okay, so I have to delete this. Let's delete this using this scissor sign. I'm deleting this, and if you do some mistake and wrongly put some circuit element which you don't want to, then you can also use this scissor to delete that. Okay, now let's again put this resistance, and along with this I am putting this work bug element in series with the resistance, then again capacitance, and let's choose this CPE constant phase element which is denoted as Q here. I am also putting this. Let's join these. Okay, now again do the fit. No, you can see that the errors has come down to 13% almost, 13.5%. So you can get the values from here. The software is fitting. It will take some time to complete. Yeah, finally you can see that 13% error in this circuit. So you have to change, you have to alter the circuit properly. You have to choose the circuit elements properly, and you have to justify whatever you have chosen later. You cannot choose anything arbitrarily. You have to justify your circuit. So I can further alter this circuit. I can make some changes in this circuit to reduce this error. But I must justify whatever I have done. You can put a capacitance here, another. I am deleting this. Okay. Now let's put resistance and a capacitance in series with it, and another capacitance here, that's CPE, that constant phase element, resistance along with a workbook element, and let's join these elements. Again, do the fitting. Now the error has come down to almost 12.6%, which is not so good also. And in this context, I want to mention that this type of circuits are highly debatable, and there may be some controversy as well. So whatever you have to do, you have to justify what you have chosen. Okay, you can see that it's almost 12.6%. It will take some time to finish. Go, it's finished, and you can find the final error is 0.1259. That's almost 12.59%. Okay, so I think you have understood the basic of how to do the fitting using this CHI software. Thank you for watching. Hope we'll meet you later. Thank you.